As I say, I don't want to get rid of all of it, but I do not believe that our entire upland should be reduced to a monoculture.
I've been really, really impressed by the quality of the debate today, the things that I've been to, by the hugeness of it. You know, there's so many people here from different parts of the food system.
We got bigger and bigger year by year, and now the only place we can that can accommodate everybody is the town hall, where you can get 500 in at any one time.
It was tiny the first year, but there was a spirit, slightly anarchic in a positive way, slightly disorganised. But there's an evolution and a growth, I think, and there is a more mature discussion and a more balanced discussion going on, which I think is very important because, of course, across the road here we've got the other Oxford Farming Conference, at which I've been a speaker on several previous years, where it is, let's be honest, largely the old ideas and the current orthodoxy, with people reinforcing their own view of what how things should be.
There is a particular issue that was one of the things that I was keen to hear more about today that drew me here, which is that conventional farmers are complaining a lot about the black grass problem, the weed problem and soil quality problems, and whether they should be looking to improve their soil organic matter and maybe bringing livestock onto farms in order to deliver that. Well, I come here and that's absolutely what everyone's talking about.
And so what we're doing here is giving people the tools, the understanding, the knowledge.
This conference is a really essential gathering. I think we're all here because we recognise that the food and farming system that we have is fundamentally defective. It's broken because of some very bad assumptions about how it works, because we have the wrong objectives about what we wanted to do, and these are leading us down a path that's taking us somewhere we don't want to go.
People that are here are the kind of people that will go out, talk to their friends, talk to their communities, talk to the people they work with, and discuss these really important issues about food, future of food and farming. So it's actually crucial that we're here, but also that we're out. We go out and spread the word and act like a mycelium out there in the wider world about real food and farming.
People don't believe, in a sense, their own power. It's almost as if human beings don't even really believe in themselves. They don't really trust themselves to do things, don't really trust each other to do good things. And they think that if we're going to achieve anything at all, we have to leave it to the powers that be. And that, more and more, I think people are beginning to see, is not true. Communities can buy land, communities can run farms, communities can employ farmers, communities can set up their own markets. Our power is tremendous, it's just a question of using it. One of the snags, of course, is, as Oscar Wilde said, always good for a quote, the trouble with democracy, it takes up too many evenings. Well, it does, but what we want to demonstrate here at the Oxford Your Farming Conference is that actually having your evenings taken up can be really quite fun, even better than watching the telly. So, you know, this is what we're about.